Hi, in this video, we'll introduce you to the build tool Maven and describe how it's used. Maven is a tool that we'll use to compile our applications. In the handout that accompanies this video, we will install Maven and make sure that it's working. Well, now, when you start writing an application, you need somewhere to start. Most people start writing their programs in an IDE without much thought about what is happening behind the scenes. Applications are just files in a directory. You might store all of your Java libraries in a folder in your hard drive called See My Java Libraries. Your IDE will happily load the libraries from your application directory. It'll store a reference inside a project file and everything will be happy. The problem with this approach is when you try to move the program to another computer, the directories you created might not match the directories on your new computer. The problem gets much worse when you try to make sure that everyone using this program is using the same versions of libraries to compile. Luckily, there is a much better solution. Maven is a tool that helps you structure your project, knows how to compile your code, run your unit tests, assemble any artifacts, and maintains a database of dependencies your project might have. If you're from a C, C++ world, Maven is like a makefile on steroids. Now, instead of a makefile, Maven uses something called a Project Object Model File, or POM file. This is the file that describes your project, what libraries should be included, including the specific library versions, and what files should be compiled. We'll look at this file in depth in the next few videos. A dependency is a library your application requires to compile. Not only does Maven examine what libraries are required for your application, it also examines what libraries those libraries need. It builds a whole tree of dependencies. Maven looks in your local Maven repository first for these required libraries. The local Maven repository is a collection of libraries installed on your computer. It doesn't matter if you have your repository in one location and another developer has hers in a different location. The Maven installation will know the correct repository location. When you compile an application, Maven will look to find the required files in the local repository. If Maven cannot find a dependency with a specific version in your repository, it will look for the dependency in other publicly shared repositories on the internet. A build is the action of creating, compiling, and packaging your application. Every project goes through several steps or phases in its build process. You compile the code, package the code, test the code, and eventually, hopefully, you'll deploy the code. A Maven project also goes through these same steps in the Maven build lifecycle. With Maven, you can choose to start at any phase of the lifecycle. You can use Maven to compile the code. Then, when you are ready, you can move on to testing and deploying. Maven has the following default build phases that you can use: validate, compile, test, package, integration test, verify, install, and deploy. If you execute the package phase, you'll run the validate, compile, test, and package build phases. If you execute the compile phase, you will run the validate and compile build phases. You can also insert other build phases into the lifecycle, but for the most part, these are the only build phases that we will use. We've taken a quick look at how Maven works and the Maven build lifecycle. You're thinking, sounds great, you're sold, so where do we start? First, download and install the latest Maven version from the Maven website. Now, depending on what computer you're using, your install steps may be different. For this reason, I've created a PDF describing the installation for both Mac and PC. Use the correct instructions for your computer. When you're done, you should be able to type MVN version from any directory on your machine, and it will reply with the currently installed version of Maven. If you get an error, double-check your steps. Next, you're ready to learn how to create Java projects using Maven archetypes and more. See you then.